Hola mi gente, yo soy Jessica Medina and you're watching En La Escena. We're live here at the official press conference for La Soga. And stay tuned with my interview with Manny Perez and Denise Quiñones. But first, watch a clip of the movie.
Ya es hora.
Mi hijo, tú eres un muchacho muy sensible. Y nosotros no podemos darnos el lujo de ser sensibles todo el tiempo.
Where'd you find this guy?
Some deported drug dealer killed his father a while back. Now he works for me.
Luisito, soy Jenny. Yo venía aquí cada verano cuando era niña.
Recuerda de mí. Tú mataste a mi papá.
We're live here, actually, from the press conference of La Soga, con nada más y nada menos que con Manny Perez. Hi, Manny. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great.
What's up, my people?
Where in Dominican Republic is Manny Perez from?
Manny, you make it seem like Manny Perez is like important guy. No, I was born and raised in this town called Baito, Santiago. It's part of Santiago in the mountains. Mm-hmm. And I came here when I was 11 years old. I didn't know that much English. I learned English and I loved acting. So I started doing a lot of children's theater at the time. My first play was Peter Pan, where I play a pirate. I didn't know what I was doing. I was just making faces in the background.
Inspired Manny to write La Soga.
I feel that, you know, as actors, we have these voices, you know. Some actors use it and they put glasses on and they walk down the street and they pick up women and all that good stuff. That's great. Mm-hmm. I feel like I have a voice to make a change in my life and make a change in the people that I love and around me. And for example, I love my country and I want to make a change for my country. Mm-hmm. So La Soga came out of me seeing injustice about 12 years ago, a friend of mine, he's a friend of the town. He was a deported guy. He got deported from New York, and he was killed in front of me by this assassin guy, a cop that has license to kill. We call him musicario. Mm-hmm. And then I saw that in front of me, and I couldn't believe it. So I decided to write a story about that monster. Mm-hmm. But in my film, the monster has a heart. So at the beginning of the film, you actually hate the guy. At the end of the film, you fall in love with him. It's a beautiful journey that happens in it, and that's why I feel like this film captivates a great audience, because you go through a journey. It's mm-hmm. not just entertainment for the sake of entertainment. It's entertainment because it moves you. It has a little bit of drama, action, love with some girl named Denise Quiñones. And she used to be Miss Puerto Rico back in the days, but anyway, she's cute too. But no, she was actually a blessing to have in the film. You know, in the film, my character's in this corrupted, dark world, and he has no conscience, so he doesn't know right from wrong. Mm-hmm. This woman comes in who used to be his childhood friend, and she's sort of his conscience that left him, and she comes back mm-hmm. in the form of Jenny, mm-hmm. and she sort of shows him, teaches him what love is again, and sort of shows him the light. So, and that's the beauty thing of the film. There's a lot of symbolism. La Soga, it doesn't mean It means the rope, a little rope. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it's a little symbolism because it's about man being tightened in by society. And also he's being controlled, manipulated by a general that's being played by Juan Fernandez. Mm-hmm. So his whole life is always being roped. Mm-hmm. And so that's where the word la soga, and also his way of killing, he sort of le tira la soga mm-hmm. para amarrarlo y después lo suelta y después lo amarra. And that's, you know, has a lot of symbolism in regards to la soga. And
where did he think would be the most appropriate place to film the movie La Soga?
Oh, in my hometown. The incident happened in my hometown. Like, plus, it was cheaper for me to shoot there because I sort of know everybody, mm-hmm. And I can control the environment. And we didn't have that much money, so I was like, well, my cousin will let me borrow his house. My friend will let me borrow her house. My neighbor, I could use her house. So it was just way cheaper to shoot there. Plus, in pesos, mm-hmm. rinde más que en dólares. So we shot some scenes in Washington Heights in my apartment. Wow. Of Washington Heights. Mm-hmm. I actually shot a film called Washington Heights in my apartment in Washington Heights. So why not go to back to Washington Heights?
Yeah. Denise Quiñones, what made her different from any other woman that's out there, talented actress?
Well, you know what's funny? I had auditioned mm-hmm. friends of mine who were pretty popular in the business, and they were pretty great. And I'm like, wow, this is really great. But there was missing this thing, and I feel like Denise is naturally born with it. She doesn't have to. She has this thing, which is like, I don't know if the word is charisma, mm-hmm. but when she smiles, you're like, wow, man, she has this angelic thing.
Yeah.
That's the word, angelic. Mm-hmm. So the character needs this angelic figure.
Yeah.
And out of everybody that I saw, I thought of her because I met her like 10 years ago. We did a hosting thing, and I just loved her energy. She had this great energy about her. And then I'm like, wow, let me call her up because I know she was doing some acting classes and doing some plays. So let me call her up. She came in and read, and I was like, oh, man, she's so great. And that's
she was the perfect fit.
She was the perfect fit.
Now, I saw the trailer, and I saw this very hot and a passionate kiss. How easy or how hard was that?
Man, I wanted to do retakes and retakes of that kiss, but, you know, the director was like, we got it. I'm like, no, we didn't.
Why Josh Crook to direct it?
I worked with Josh Crook about 4 years ago in an independent film, and I just connected with that dude. Like, we think in imageries, and when I write in imageries. And when he shoots in images, very beautiful images. So I was like, man, this guy's great. So he's like, hey, man, I want to do another film. I'm like, well, you know, you should read the script that I wrote. And he said, what is it about? I'm like, well, it's about a kid who kills a 150-pound pig. He's like, oh, shoot it. So then he read it, loved it, and then we went out and got the money. And we connect. Like, he doesn't have to really tell me much. We became sort of best friends. So he knows what I think before I open my mouth. So that connection really adds out a lot when you're shooting a scene. Nothing has to be said. He just look at me, and I know exactly what he's thinking and vice versa. So that's a plus when you're shooting an independent film with no money.
How was the acceptance of the Dominican people, the president of República Dominicana, Leonel Fernández? Okay. Any insights on that?
Well, no, they loved it. You know, we had we did a few festivals out there, and I'll give you an example. We screamed in my hometown in Santiago, and they were applauding for like 20 minutes nonstop. Mm-hmm. Then we went to the capital, where the biggest theater there is called Teatro Nacional, and it holds 1,200 people. There were 2,200 people standing, applauding at the end of the film for like 20 minutes. So that was a great, you know, that to me is one of the most beautiful moments in my career. And those are the moments that I look for in future projects that I want to do. Mm-hmm. When we screened in Toronto, all of a sudden I get a phone call from the president. And I'm like, what? President? So he's like, yeah, well, you know, he didn't say his assistant, whatever mm-hmm. it said. Some guy, some politician guy. So he's like, yeah, the president wants to see it, and he has a flight for you. Come down this Saturday. I'm like, I'm not coming down there by myself. Are you crazy? So then I'm like, hey, can I bring someone? He's like, who? I'm like, I'll just find somebody to bring. And then I spoke to Josh. I'm like, hey, Josh, you want to come down? Nah, are you crazy? I'm not going to get arrested. So then I'm like, ah, man. So I needed to bring someone with me because, you know, I didn't want to go down there and get arrested by myself. So I decided to call Juan Fernandez, mm-hmm. who's, well, respected in the DR. I invited him to come down. So we went down there, and they had like, we waited for like an hour for him because he was running late. A private theater. Mm-hmm. So I'm in the back freaking out. So
I know that you were like that because, you know, this actually talks about the corruption.
Exactly. It talks about the corruption. It talks about the DR corruption, and he even has a president in the film.
Oh, wow.
So I was like, man, you know, I'm really going to get in trouble. So I was in the back of the theater. He walks in, he shakes my hand, he sits down with his wife, and the film starts, and there's all these generals with him, and it talks about, the film talks about corrupted generals. So I'm in the back freaking out, and I'm like, ah, oh, man, sweating. I never really sweat. So the film ends, and then silence. And I'm like, oh, man, nobody's applauding. And then he started applauding, and then everybody started applauding. And then he shook my hand. He's like, hey, man, you're really great. This is great. You know, this is a reflection on my country. We're trying to make a change. This film really shows that, and I appreciate it. And that was it.
When does La Soga premiere in New York City?
August 13th, this Friday, everywhere in New York City. New Jersey, Queens, Bronx, La Soga. We have a website, lasogamovie.com, lasogamovie.com, lasogamovie.com.
Ya saben, mi gente, this is Manny Perez. For En La Escena, you have to go out there and support the movie La Soga that comes out August 13th in New York City. This is Jessica Medina reporting for En La Escena.